Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel and welcome back to the second video on our series on how to save, take, download and upload UI images in iOS and Swift 5. Now, in the previous episode, we have talked how you can save an image into your photo library. Today, we are going to talk about how you can save it in a separate dedicated folder. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay, let me just build and run this project and show you, or rather yet, let us just add in here some more code. And after we have unwrapped our image, I will just simply start the activity indicator. So start animating. So let's just build and run. If you are new here, go ahead and take a look at the first video. So what we are trying to achieve here, let's unlock our device because we are using our device. We are taking a photo. So there we go. Let's take a close photo of, and there we go. That's me there. And let's use this photo. And now when we tap on save, we should be able to see the activity indicator till we get the alert, UI alert, that we have a saved photo. Oh, there's too much dust on my computer screen. So let's hit save there. And image saved successfully. It was kind of instant, but let's hit OK there. And let's just double check if we do have that. There we go. We have saved that into our photos library. Great. So today, what we want to do is create an album and then save it to our photo library. Well, that is kind of hard to do and code out. So, lucky for you, I have created a class for that. And go ahead and click the link down below if you haven't already done so to see your resources. And there you will see a custom album.swift file and an error plus swift file. If you don't know about custom errors, go ahead and take a look at the file and at my video on how to create your very own custom errors. Okay, so that's basically it. So what we want to do is drag both of these into Xcode. So let's just add that in there. And now we are able to have the power of this custom album NS object, it's a class basically. Then we can create our albums. So let's go back and let's uncomment this UI image write to save photos album. And what we are basically want to use is save to album, this function. So let's add that in here, save to album. And the name will be, let's say, Swift 5 UI image, or whatever you would like that to be called. And the image we will provide is the image that we have unwrapped from the image views image. Okay, now let's go, that's it. Basically, when we are tapping on save photo, we will be calling upon this save to album function. So let's talk about this save to album. Okay, now one thing that you need to know about this custom album.swift file is that it's very easy to use, and this is how you could do it. So first of all, you need to create an album. Album, there we go, equals, and this will be a custom album, and you can name your custom album or for whatever you would like, but I am going to use this named property that we have added to the save to album function. Now, one final thing is to grab album and type in save, and there we go. We have an image, so that will be our image, and we have a completion handler with the Swift 5's brand new results type. Go ahead and take a look at that in the channel because I'm covering it in depth, so you may understand what this is all about. So if we tap on there, we get back a result. That result is has a boolean value and an error. So let's type in here result, and now let's take care of this result. So we are going to use the same old switch statement result here, and let's just wait for the auto completion to nag about this. So switch must be exhaustive. Okay, let's fix this. It's a real time saver. Okay, now for success, we are going to leave this as is because it's just a boolean value. But for failure, we are going to add in here our error. And what we want to do here is, well, we could print out the error, but we are going to simply just use this present alert function. So let's go there, present alert, there we go. And the title will be error, and the message will be error dot localized description, and that takes care of that. Now if we do have a success, or let's just fix this compiler error there. So if we do have successfully saved the image, then we want to say to the user that okay, we have successfully saved this to our custom album. Now just think about it, this is handled on a background thread, so most probably you already know we want to call upon our dispatch queue main. So let's do that here, dispatch queue dot main dot async, and let's just copy and paste the switch onto there. Okay, there we go. So why do I want to add this? First of all, because of the alert, but yeah, maybe I switch to the alert in later time on a dispatch queue. But now we want to basically stop the activity animator, so activity indicator, we want to stop it, and that needs to be on the main thread. So let's just create the success alert, and there we go, success. And now let's type in successfully, and maybe let's add in the album name too. Let's go here. Alright, right, let me just show you a neat little trick how you can add these quotation marks. There we go, named. Let's close that off. That should be okay. Okay, so basically that is it, and everything is taken care of by the custom Albert album class. So let's build and run, and let's see how this will work. Okay, build has succeeded, that is great. So let's wait for this to launch. Let's take a photo. There we go. Use photo. And now let's save it. So now, as you recall, we have added the privacy. So this app wants to use your photo library, and that is because we want to save some images. So let's hit OK there. Successfully saved photo to album and Swiftify UI image. And I believe we have some errors here, so quite typos. Let's see there, and it's a small M. Okay, fix that. Let's go back to our QuickTime player and let's hit OK, and that is it. Now let's double check. So let's go back to our photos, and if we select albums, we should be able to see all, and let's just scroll all the way down, and there we have it. Swift UI image. It's a with a capital M, but hey, that is okay for now. There we go, we have our image saved in our custom folder. Now that is it for this episode. In the previous one, we have saved our image to our photo library, basic stuff. Now we have saved it into our custom folder. Now in the next one, we are going to upload our photo, and guess where? to Firebase storage. Yes, that is right. So if you did like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. It helps a lot. And subscribe to the channel if you already haven't done so, and hit that notification bell. Now it is your turn. Go ahead and create your custom albums and save your photos in there. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.